Hi! Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your Lord's Day Sunday afternoon Devo. Today is Sunday, January 30th, 2022. And we're going to be... This is episode 615, part number 2, your Daily Bread passage. And we're going to be talking about unanswered prayers from John Blaise Blase, however it's pronounced. But it would probably be pronounced Blaise. Because if it don't, the little E, the E would have a little mark over it, then it would be Blase. But it's not, so. But if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Comment something that you have prayed about and it has gone unanswered. But it always, those unanswered prayers always bring forth something else. God may not think that you want, that you need, that he doesn't think you need that as much as you think you do. So he doesn't answer those prayers. So tell me something that you've always prayed about as a Christian, but something that has never been answered. What is that one unanswered prayer that has gone unanswered? Subscribe if you do. Turn on notifications. Share the video and channel with your family and friends and help me reach that 100 subscriber mark, hopefully by my birthday, which is April 18th. So, you'll have to forgive me because in between recording this morning's video and now, I was in process of getting ready to upload this morning's video from where I'm sitting, and I opened up a Slim Jim. I opened this thing up and went to bite it like this, and went to pull off a big piece so I could chew on it for a couple minutes before I got ready to record again. But when I bit down like this, I had a tooth up here pop out. I mean, it just popped out. All it was holding was the gum line, and I was able to push up. And the funny thing is, it didn't bleed, but I was able to push it up and pop the whole piece of tooth out, and I put it over there. It's the same tooth that broke out on me one night during dinner before my brother was killed in that crash. I think it was back in September, August or September, when we went to a barbecue restaurant. I was eating alone, bit down on a piece of meat, and pop, just the same way that one just did. So. And then I popped it loose and brought it home, stuck it. And then I kept having a funny feeling in the front. This piece is on the front part. And now I got a big old gap in my teeth. And I'm not going to show it to you. It might gross you out. Because I got a couple teeth up here that are half broke up here. Sorry. I'm not going to show it to you. It may gross you out. But it's right there, a tooth right there, and man, that feels weird, the weirdest feeling ever, to have the tooth on the front. It was alright getting used to it on the back, but now it's on the front part, oh man, that feels weird. It's going to be worse when I try to eat something. I'm going to get much of stuff stuck up there, and I thought, oh well, I'll quit rambling about that. So, probably grossing people out talking about teeth. Bad teeth. But unanswered prayers, John writes, are we there yet? Not yet. Are we there yet? Not yet. That was the back and forth game we played on the first and definitely not the last 16-hour trip back home to Arkansas from Colorado when our children were young. Our oldest two kept the game alive, and well, if I had a dollar for every time they asked, well, I'd have a stack of dollars. It was a question my children were obsessed with, but I, the driver, was equally obsessed wondering are we there yet? And the answer was, not yet, but soon. So truth be told, most adults are asking a variation on that question, although we may not voice it out loud, but we're asking for the same reason. We're tired. Our eyes have grown weak with sorrow. Psalm 6, verse 7. We're worn out from our groaning. Verse 6. About everything from the nightly news to daily frustration at work to never-ending health problems to relationship strains, and the list goes on. We cry out, are we there yet? How long, Lord? How long? So the psalmist knew well that kind of weariness, and he honestly brought the key question to God. So like a caring parent, he heard David's cry, and in his great mercy accepted them. Verse 9, there was no shame for asking. Likewise, you and I can boldly approach our Father in heaven when our honest cries of how long, and his answer might be, not yet, but soon. I'm good, trust me. And so like, you make a prayer and it goes unanswered. Like I was asking you in the beginning. The thing just goes on and on. God may not think you need it, so he doesn't answer it. But truly, you thank God sometimes for those unanswered prayers, because if those prayers were answered, some people might have had unanswered prayers, and they might not have ended up where they are today. Like the song by Garth Brooks, Unanswered Prayers. The story of the song goes, him and his wife went to a football game, and he ran into his high school flame. And while they were in school, he'd asked God to make it possible to get together with this girl. Time and time again, he wanted to be with her forever. He wanted to be that man and wife with that woman or that girl. But that prayer went unanswered. And he met this other woman. And he looks at the situation, and boom. He realized, thank God, that prayer wasn't answered, which gave me a chance to be over here. And now he's had three beautiful young daughters, or three beautiful daughters with this one woman. They divorced because they couldn't live in any same house, but they're still best friends. They're still good friends. And then he met this other woman, Trisha Yearwood, and they're married. And that's the best thing that happened to him. Now, if he had been man and wife with this other girl, who knows where he would have been? Who knows what he ended up? I believe that was a life story song. So look it up, take a listen to it, and go along with this passage. But why are you weary right now and wondering, how long, Lord? What is it about God that shows he's trustworthy? Ponder those questions. And like I've always said, put a proverbial answer in the comments if you feel like it. You don't have to, but ponder that by saying, Father in heaven, the burdens of this world have me asking, how long? Thank you for welcoming such prayers, and please give me the strength to trust you in life's journey. I try to say it a little slow so you can keep, so you like, if you want to write it down, you can follow. You're like, okay, okay, okay. But if you have to back the video up to do it, you'll be able to hear it all. I wish I could put the words to every time I read on these videos, read that part and have the words at the bottom. I don't haven't figured how to do that yet. But your Bible reading today is Exodus 23 and 24 and Matthew 20, 1 through 16. The first half of Matthew verse. And I don't know whether you noticed it yesterday when I said the Bible reading was Matthew 19, the whole chapter. Well, the passage in yesterday's, in your Saturday's Daily Bread passage, your part two, which would have been about 5:30 last night, it went live. So last night's part two, yesterday's part two, the passage was derived from Matthew 19, and it was verses 16 to 26. But you had to read the whole book. You don't have to read, but it was giving you a portion to read the whole chapter. It's like you just went through those few verses. Now it's the whole verse. I noticed that when I said, wait a minute, that's the same passage that's up there. Now that is unreal. But I'll stop rambling about that. I'm going over a little bit more than I wanted to do, but coming up tomorrow in your very last Daily Bread of January, for your last Fantastic Monday, January 31st, 2022, and part two of episode 616, we are going to be talking about unapologetic tears from Elisa Morgan. E-L-I-S-A. Elisa. Elisa. However it's pronounced on that one. But it's Elisa Morgan. Elisa Morgan. And it is derived from Luke 7:36-44. So stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes. But you'll see that one tomorrow. Coming up tonight in your final weekend series Devo for the Are You Ready for a New Year series. Your fifth and final video of the month. And your last R of a new year. New Year's Relocation. We're going to begin with Genesis 19:14. The recommended reading is Philippians 3:12-14. The turning point is from Johnson Oatman, O-A-T-M-A-N, Oatman, Jr., from a hymn or poem or something called I'm Pressing on the Upward Way, and it sounds like a hymn when I read it. And your Bible reading for the weekend is Leviticus 5-10. So I hope you read 5, 6, and 7 yesterday. If you choose to read the read like this, and you read 8, 9, 10 today. So, but that's what's coming up tonight. So, with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Sorry for the little rambling. But sometimes you get devos that you have to ramble a little bit on a subject just to explain yourself of what they're talking about. It's always good to explain certain parts that you're talking about so people will understand what you're talking about. So, but with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Lord's Day, Sunday afternoon. Come back again tonight for the fifth and final Are You Ready for a New Year Devo, New Year's Relocation. I can't wait to finish that one out. And the February one, it's going to be another goodie. So, but with that said, goodbye.